Gamelot331 here, and it's happened at GameStop. Morale has hit an all-time low. And I know what you're thinking. How can it get any lower than it is currently? I don't know. I was thinking the same thing as I was saying that. I have no answers for you. But I do know that GameStop is releasing their 2020 plan, finally. Their 2020 plan. And this has their associates in shambles, and morale is hitting the floor. And guess who has, for you, the 2020 plan in document form from corporate? This guy. How do I get all these things? I don't know. They just appear in front of me. And I'm just like, here, I guess I'll show everybody this thing I got. You get to see it first before even most of the associates are going to probably see it. So you heard it here first, folks. And I also have some employee messages that are really heartbreaking. And we'll go over that as well. This is just heartbreaking. It's the end, my friend. I hope that's not a song, because now we're copyrighted. But before we get into it, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, doodle. It means a lot to me. It means so damn much. And make sure you subscribe if you haven't. We're so close to the goal. Get on it, dog. So let's get into this spicy ass sauce. The first message I got. Man, Cammy, I'm feeling bad. Everyone in my store is depressed. Morale is terrible. We have people in our store and neighboring stores getting fired almost every week from tech trades. Ooh, tech trades, damn. It's like a nightmare. People I've worked with for years that are generally awesome associates. I've seen these people sell a console and 10 pre-owned games to someone just looking for a charger, and they're getting fired for tech trades, which I think is insane. I've literally seen this before. They are fired over COL back when I was there, and these associates could sell anything, but they just were getting beaten COL. Good associates gone for no reason. He goes on to say, we are just really down. Thanks for giving us a voice. We always look out for your videos, and we love your Amazon, Lowe's, and just general story videos. He also says, by the way, COL is coming back in a huge way, if it was ever really gone. We will be getting terminated if we don't hit a certain goal in each category. And I don't know if you remember, but this was a big story when COL first became a thing at GameStop. It was all over IGN and Kotaku. Well, it's coming back, he says. Is that the 2020 plan I have to discuss with you later? Hoo-hoo, we'll see. Wait till the end of the video to see that. Next one, the next message I got. Hey, I have something about tech trades in GameStop. We have an associate that just lies and writes bogus information down in the quote binder. The DL doesn't care. The DL has terminated our store leader and another associate because they refuse to lie and harass people. That associate is just lying, which I guess is the thing to do, because he just got promoted to store leader. Shocking. Oh my God, it's like an egg situation. He even bragged that he's lying his way to the top. Nothing against him. He's playing it smart. I just feel bad for this SL I had for 3 years. In my opinion, that's kind of, I mean, he's basically dodging a bullet. You know, he's lying to get these numbers, so he's lying to the DL, but he's not having to rob associates on the other end. So maybe I prefer that, you know, because it's about the customers. It's about not robbing the customers, right? That's the whole goal here. But these are two messages out of hundreds I've got of morale. And I know what you're thinking. It's like, oh, well, it's just messages the Camelot's reading. Well, let's go to a place that's usually cult-like and see how morale is there. And that is Reddit GameStop. r/GameStop, which is kind of like a cult and it's kind of creepy sometimes. But is morale even bad there? Which this entire Reddit is pretty much associates only. So, this guy right here says, everyone has a phone. The DL says this constantly. Have 5 emails just today about tech trades. Does any employee respond positively from nagging? It makes me not want to put any additional effort when I know my coworkers and I are just going to be harassed every other hour. We're supposed to ask every single guest what phone they have. Which is creepy as hell. I agree, Mr. Reddit guy. Mr. O7. I agree, man. Look at some of these comments. Sarah Spartan says, all jokes aside, legitimately, this phone trade obsession is going to be what kills the company. What kills the crab? A response. It makes it look like they have no interest in GameStop as a business when their focus has nothing to do with the business. And I agree. And it's because they're just selling them to other countries in bulk to get profit so they can get the hell out of there. You know what I'm saying? Dylan, who is an assistant store leader, responds, thing is, GameStop is making so much profit off most of these phones we get in. Go look up the wholesale website. You'll understand why they're pushing phone trades so hard. And it's a wholesale website where they sell phones to other countries, basically. And somebody right here says, so what happens when people run out of devices to sell? And Dylan says, that's when we start trading in people's cars for credit. It's crazy. And these are associates. The morale is crashing. Look at this person. They're a customer. As a longtime customer, I say this whole phone thing is very annoying. It just pushes me to not want to go in. I'm glad my local stores don't even ask me because I'm a regular and they know by now. This guy right here who works at GameStop says, if I was asked every time as a guest, I would stop coming in. I mean, they're pushing customers away, and the employees are having to face the brunt of this. They're getting drilled by their DLs, and the DLs are getting drilled by the RLs. That's all it's about. They're getting drilled, and they're making these people harass people. This one right here says, only 5 trades? My DL has stores emailing him every time they get a win, tech trade or high volume trade, and then forward said emails to all the stores in the district, which is basically just shoving their face in it. So we get an email every single time another store gets a tech trade, basically a way of shoving it in our faces that other stores are doing so much better than us because I can't control if someone comes in and trades, which is true. People on this Reddit may think I'm a naysayer, but this company has lost sight of what it could have been. I have fond memories, even met my wife working at GameStop. Our store was once the best place I had ever worked. Why? We never had things like this breathing down our necks. It was all about games, customer service, and treating people fairly. Make them want to shop with you. That's what I talked about in my email to the CEO of GameStop. I was like, make people want to be your customer for life. They're not worried about that. This phone thing is going to kill them. All that mattered in those times were reservation and pro, with a smattering of GPGs thrown in there. We never had to worry about hitting our goals as we treated every customer with genuine service and care. They wouldn't go anywhere else. Our staff was tenured, often with other jobs. We even had a cop who worked here evenings for us as a GA to pay his gaming habit. No bickering, no turnover. I spent my mornings opening by and large doing the task assigned when every customer who come in, it was usually, hey John, how are you? Hey Susan, how's the kids doing? Almost everyone was known and fiercely loyal. So it's sad. Morale is apparently bad on the Reddit as well. But I like this one right here. Check this out. I see a lot of negativity about our jobs as GameStop employees, and I mean, I get it. It seems like a lot of the times the company doesn't use common sense and doesn't listen to the average guys and gals like us. But it's still a great job. Being ex-military, trust me, when I say it, it could be a lot worse. We still get discounts on games and we love to get surrounded by a community that loves games too. You're gonna have it bad wherever you go, so leave it up. Gotta make the best of what you got. Look at the first response. Cool. Hey, what phone are you writing this message on? Did you know we do tech trades for up to $500 cash this holiday season? I smell corporate infiltrator. This one right here. You're going to have it bad wherever you go is one hell of a mindset to have in life. So as you can see, if an echo chamber like r/Reddit, which is cultish as hell, can also have an extreme morale issue right now, then probably the entire company is having that issue. But why? Is it because of the 2020 plan that has been announced that I have for you right now? COL is coming back, and it's coming back in a big way. You guys get ready. Before Kotaku and anyone else is on the subject, you heard it from the Famalot. Here it is, the new 2020 COL from GameStop. So as you can see here, it says, new for 2020 dashboard, store and district scorecards, which is what they call the COL, the Circle of Life scorecard. The scorecard starts with behavioral metrics. Ooh, behavioral metrics. That's terrifying. It's like you're in another country, you know what I'm saying? Tech trades weigh 20% of this rank. Warranty attach, another 20. And power rewards ratio, another 20. So that's 60. Tech trades being basically weighing the most tied to these. Hardware attach is 15. Units per transaction is 15. And the reserve ratio is 10. Which bring you to 100%, which tech trades is the number one thing. Huh, selling to the items in bulk to other countries is how they're trying to get their profit for the entire year of 2020. Isn't that insane? A place called GameStop is relying on their profit by selling tech trades to other countries that have nothing to do with GameStop. What a weird long distance this company has fallen. Here's the other side of this metric, which has to do with sales. Okay, and you would think this would be all sales. Well, here we go. Sales versus plan, 20%. That's their sales over their last year sales plus what's predicted. The pre-owned sales over plan, which I'm assuming that's pre-owned games over plan, 20% as well. But what is the highest of all? behavioral 30%, which is this right here. So not only does this have a weight itself, it also comes into factor here. So you have 30% here as well in behavioral. And then there's trade dollars versus plan 15 and UPLH versus plan 15, weighing 100%. So basically, it's all tech trades and power-up rewards. So the new card that doesn't get you anything off pre-owned games gives you a $5 coupon that does not roll over every month. And you can't use it on reserves. A lot of employees will tell you, oh, you get this $5 coupon every month. They don't tell you it expires because they're not going to. They've been told not to tell you. They've been told to lie to you and not tell you that. Well, that's how that works. And these people are saying that they will be fired instantly if they don't hit every one of these metrics on the new 2020 COL scorecard. Are you guys ready? It's coming. Tech trades, behavioral, sales versus plan. It's all coming. It's coming together. It's here, right here. So when you go into these stores, you will be asked about tech trades, warranties, power-up rewards, hardware, units per transaction, which is having multiple things on a transaction, and reserve ratio, all tied into one. Six things tied in to every transaction while you're in their stores. We're at the end, guys. This is it. This is it. So that's the new 2020 scorecard, and that's what has everyone upset, and that's why morale is down. So a little update, a tiny update. COL is back. 2020 has started. The scorecard has been announced, and it has all the associates upset. So that's all I have today. Make sure if you work at GameStop, you message me. Message me and let me know what's going on within your store. If you work anywhere, you can do that. Message me if you work anywhere. I'm trying to tell everything and put out every piece of information I can that is concerning these associates in these stores. I want them to know, because otherwise they may not know. So if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up doodle, and make sure you subscribe if you haven't. I'm here for all of you. You guys keep me going every day, and I hope I can repay in any way I can. So until next time, make sure you get on it. Doggone it. Bye. Yeah.